Good morning and welcome to Wigmore Hall from me, Catherine Bott. Taking to the stage in a moment will be three of our current artists in residence, Trio Gaspard, who put themselves firmly on the international musical map in 2012 when they won the Joseph Haydn Chamber Music Competition in Vienna. In September this year, the Strad magazine called their Haydn concert here an exuberant exhibition of vitality. And today, as well as a Haydn trio, they'll be playing music by Dvořák and his favourite pupil and son-in-law, Josef Suk. All three members of Trio Gaspard, who hail from Germany, Greece and the UK, are established soloists in their own right. As a trio, they work regularly with contemporary composers, as well as exploring the traditional piano trio repertoire. And that's where they're going to start. The father of the piano trio is Haydn. Over his long career, he wrote 46 of them, which developed from comparatively simple works, more like accompanied piano sonatas, into absorbing, complex pieces like the one we're going to hear this morning, the trio in E minor, written in the late 1780s. After a declamatory opening flourish, the first movement gives hints of brighter thoughts to come in the limpid second movement and playful finale, both of them in the major key. Volume 1 of Trio Gaspard's complete Haydn trio recordings was declared by reviewers truly a delight which leaves the listener hungry for more. So, to satisfy that hunger with Haydn's Trio No. 12, let's welcome violinist Jonian Ilias Kadesha, cellist Vashti Hunter, and pianist Nicholas Rimmer, Trio Gaspard.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Haydn's piano trio in E minor played with zest and a keen sense of fun. Haydn would have loved that. By trio Gaspard, who are artists in residence this season here at Wigmore Hall. And the second volume of their complete Haydn trio recordings is out now, ideal for Christmas presents. I talked to violinist Jonian Ilias Kadesha this morning and asked him about the trio's ongoing preoccupation with Haydn, and he said, well, Haydn created the language of this repertoire, and his 46 trios have endless variety. All human life is there. How can we not play them? This morning's recital is part of the Cavatina Chamber Music Trust's ticket scheme, which offers free tickets to those aged between 8 and 25. And this live stream is also free to enjoy at home. But please do consider making a donation, or better still, becoming a friend of Wigmore Hall to support this unique home of music making all the year round. That Haydn trio was written in the key of E minor, said by the 19th century theorist Hermann von Helmholtz to be a key that represents grief, mournfulness and plaintiveness. Trio Gaspard will also end their concert in E minor with the Dumky trio, one of Dvořák's best-known works. Dumky is a word of Ukrainian origin, the plural of dumka, which is in turn the diminutive of duma, a lamenting ballad sung by captive people. And over the six movements of the trio, written just over a century after Haydn's, we'll hear half a dozen Dumky melodies incorporated into a work that's been called a dark fantasia, a completely original work. Before we surrender ourselves to that, Trio Gaspard play an equally atmospheric miniature by Dvořák's student and later son-in-law, Josef Suk. His elegy was written in 1902 for a memorial event honouring the life of the novelist Julius Zeyer, whose stories were steeped in Bohemian history and legend. It's inspired, this elegy, by an ancient fortress on a rock overlooking the city of Prague. So, to take us to Bohemian lands in music by Suk, followed by Dvořák, we welcome back Trio Gaspard.
Thank you.
Gaspard with Dvořák's trio in E minor, opus 90, known as the Dumky, after the traditional laments woven throughout the music. It was first performed in Prague in the spring of 1891 with the composer at the piano, and it was so well received that Dvořák then performed it on a 40-concert tour of Moravia and Bohemia before he left for the United States. The work was published while he was in the USA, so it was proofread by none other than his friend Johannes Brahms. In the words of Trio Gaspard, that's a piece you can't not play. Throughout, it's so wonderful that the music turns in an instant from darkness to hope. And they've given us all a lot of hope on this rather dull grey morning in London. From here in Wigmore Hall, it's all light. The origins of Trio Gaspard's name come from darkness. Gaspard de la Nuit, Ravel's great piano masterpiece, he is the custodian of the treasures of the night. And it was a piece by Ravel with which the trio made their debut a dozen years ago. So they thought they'd go with Gaspard. I think they may have something else to play for us. They did say they might, and I think we'd like it.
Thank you so much. We will say, usually I say we will say good night, but I just realized it's morning. So we will play for you a little piece by a pianist, composer, and a very good friend of ours, Kit Armstrong. He wrote this piece for us, and it's a series of little compositions that we have commissioned as a kind of a homage to Haydn. So here is one of them. It has the title Revêtement, and you can check out what that means. I don't thank you.
Trio Gaspard, Jonian, Ilias, Kadesha, Vashti Hunter and Nicholas Rimmer, with a homage to Haydn written specially for them by Kit Armstrong. Revêtement. And a revetment, in case you didn't know, I expect you did, is a protective barricade, a retaining wall. And I think today, music making like that acts as a barricade against gloom, much needed. Trio Gaspard will be back here on the 30th of January. Their programme hasn't yet been announced, but it's bound to be absorbing. Meanwhile, next Sunday morning, Kator Agat plays Bartok and Brahms, and on December the 3rd, you can hear not only Wagner's Tannhäuser Overture in an epic arrangement for two pianos, but also Gershwin's An American in Paris. A terrific way to spend a Sunday morning here at Wigmore Hall. For now, though, it's goodbye from me, Catherine Bodd, and Gio Gaspard. Until the next time.